Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with a new video where I want to show you how we can use macros with a custom markup plugin. Yeah, and the example will be the copy to clipboard macro. Yeah, okay, let's search the macro first. The clipboard.clip macro is part of the example macro, so I made a global macro here. And there is some pre-configured custom markup syntax. Yeah, I'll copy paste this because it's easier. Yeah, okay, so let's make this bigger and copy this information. Yeah, in normal cases, let's start with the clip macro. The clip macro looks like this. Yeah, so it defines the name dot clip, and then it only has a parameter code. Yeah, and then there is some HTML which will be created. Then there is the macro call copy to clipboard, which uses the copy to clipboard macro, which is part of TillyWiki. Yeah. Then it inserts the code, and then it creates a pre-code element with the code in it. Yeah? So there is only one parameter which is needed. And we can predefine this with the clip macro like this. So custom, in this case we use the degree macro, the degree glyph, yeah? So this one, which is called degree. And we give it a name. Yeah, and the name then is clip. Yeah. I use capital letters now. Yeah. Clip, so that makes it more clear. Example. And then there is clip one line. Yeah. Then it needs the definition of an element. Yeah. So we have already seen that we can pass HTML elements to those glyphs. Yeah. But it's also possible to give it macro calls. Yeah, so if you know the macro name, then this is dollar macro call, which is the widget macro call. Then it needs the name of the widget, and this is dot clip. Yeah, then it needs the source name. The source in this case is this. Yeah? So the text that will be used is called the source, and the source name is code. Yeah. So if we have a look at the macro again, it says the name is clip and the source or the parameter is code. Yeah. And this information is needed also here, yeah, the code. Then it needs to render the whole thing in block mode. Yeah. So clip, block mode. So. And then it needs an end string. Yeah. In normal cases, degree stops with one line. Yeah. So, and I gave it here. Yeah. So the default setting is like this. So if I call it with one line, then it only uses one line. If I want to have several lines, I need to define an end string. Yeah. Let's define it here. So we give it the degree and then clip. Yeah. Then you can see. Ah, this is clip, this is the paragraph, clip minus one. Then you can see it uses only one line. Yeah? If I say clip, yeah, and I want to use, let's say, two lines, yeah, then I give it an end string and I use clip. Yeah? Then it's in the, it inserts the code until it finds this end string. Yeah? So clip one is one line and clip needs an end string. Yeah, and that's already basically it. Yeah? So if I say clip here and then I add this code element, this single bracket, oops, control X, I want to have it here. So, yeah. Now you can see there is the code. Yeah? And here I say copy to clipboard. If I click it, it's copied to the clipboard, and if I create a new tiller, then it's copied to the clipboard. Copy paste it, that's it. And the same thing can be done with example. So if I define example, example also has an end string. So let's move it to here. Then you have this try it button, where you can see how it is rendered. So the example first renders the code, and then there is the try it button like this. As you know, there are already macros, but in my case I want to have wiki text, so where I can say, okay, I want to have an example and the example starts or stops here, without all the stuff that is needed. For example, in the at tilwiki.com there is the field mangler widget examples. There you have all this boilerplate, so this is macro call name example and one and so on. And I don't want to have these elements. I just want to have let's say a little bit of wiki text. That's basically it, how we can use macros. So we have the possibility to define custom elements, custom degree, then give it a name, and then predefine all the parameters that are needed by the macro call. And then the macro call is as simple as this. Give it the degree, example, and then this is the source until it finds the end string. Then there is a possibility with one line. If I don't define an end string, and the degree stops with the first line. That's basically it with the definition of how can we copy to clipboard and how can we use the example. In the next video we will have a closer look about this presentation, but there I have to say it's not finished yet, but I give you a little overview. Have fun and see you soon.